Have you ever had the thought in your mind of, this isn't working? Like, this isn't working the way I anticipated it would be. And it's one thing if you're complaining about something that you bought off of Amazon, or if you're maybe having a similar struggle in a hotel room or on a trip abroad. But have you ever had this feeling with some of the more consequential things of life? Thinking this maybe about your marriage or even your friendships of, this isn't working. Something's broken. Something isn't functioning the way that it was supposed to. Maybe even more troubling is, have you ever had this show up in the process of trying to follow God? Of going, something's messed up. Something isn't working. And why do we feel that way? Because so many of us had this experience of, we heard a message or we read the Bible or something compelling us, which we believe was the Holy Spirit, compelling us to make this crucial life decision to invite Jesus into our lives. So we did that. We prayed the prayer, and yet it feels like on the other side, sometimes it feels like nothing has actually changed. That the same habits are still there. The same pain is still there. You still wrestle with the same hurts. And maybe you've even felt a little bit of a buyer's remorse. Like somehow your spirituality was like the beginning of an infomercial on TV late at night, where it was like, if you want peace of mind, if you want joy that surpasses understanding, then just pray this one prayer. And if you pray it right now, bonus, we'll throw in a healthy marriage. We'll throw in fulfilling friendships. And you're like, yes, I'm all in. And then on the other side, you're like, but wait, this didn't deliver on what I thought it would. It sounded so great, and yet you prayed the prayer, you put in your heavenly order, and yet it feels like something was never delivered. And at times you can find yourself going, God, this just isn't working. And adding to the confusion is that sometimes it's not working for you, and yet it seems to be working splendidly for someone else. I mean, for centuries, for millennia, people have been committing their lives to follow Christ, and it's made a drastic difference for them. You can look through history and see story after story of people whose lives have been transformed through their faith in Christ. Maybe there are even personal, close relationships to you that they can't stop talking about what Jesus has done for them. And yet when you're around them, while you desire what they have, there's a part of you that goes, but I already did that, and it just doesn't seem to be working for me. And if you're there right now, here's the question that we have to ask. What if it's not working because something is missing? What if there's a crucial detail that we've bypassed? Like me, not knowing that there was a hot water heater that I needed to flip a switch to turn on. What if there's a crucial part of our Christianity that's been missing, that's causing us to actually miss out on the good things that God has for us? Now, the good news for us is that this struggle isn't unique to us. In fact, as we continue looking at the book of James, we find him connecting the dots on some crucial details that are easy to miss.